I'll start by making one thing perfectly clear. Donald Trump has my strong endorsement, period.
Trump's biggest primary rival, Nikki Haley, was met with cheers as she stepped into the spotlight as a last-minute addition to the RNC lineup in hopes of turning a new era of a united Republican Party.
USA! I've never seen our party more unified than we are right now. Unified behind Donald Trump. I mean, my gosh, when he walked into that arena last night, the cheers from people, the whole place was basically shaking.
You invite Nikki Haley to the convention and speak in a very prime time slot, and that's really an important part of bringing people together.
We spoke to delegates from Nikki Haley's home state of South Carolina and Vermont, where she won the state, to see if they felt her speech could convince her supporters to vote for Trump.
But it's about uniting the whole country, and it's a good thing for Nikki Haley to be here. It's nice for President Trump to invite her, and it shows her the unity that our party wants to bring to this country.
And I think her speech was fantastic. She showed that she's ready to unite and come back as a unity so we can take back the country and put Donald Trump back in office.
Sort of counterintuitive move for Trump to really build a council of his rivals. That's something we haven't really seen him do before. And the fact that he changed his mind after this weekend, decided to invite Nikki Haley, was a big move. And I think Nikki Haley made the case that reminding Trump that not everyone agrees with him 100%.
You don't have to agree with Trump 100% of the time to vote for him.
And yet also helping Nikki Haley voters who aren't sure they are supporting Trump to know, look, I've been with Trump behind the scenes. He listens to different perspectives. And I think that's the kind of thing that can give some Haley voters a little more comfortability voting for Trump that they might not have had if she wasn't able to speak here tonight.
If we have four more years of Biden or a single day of Harris, our country will be badly worse off. For the sake of our nation, we have to go with Donald Trump.
But not every Republican believes the party is unified around Trump.
Trump and the MAGA movement really deal in a politics of personality. So they think if they can put Nikki Haley on the stage or Ron DeSantis on the stage, that all of a sudden everybody will just sort of fall in line.
The principal's first founder, Heath Mayo, called Trump's 2024 platform a 16-point set of all-cap sentences and a pretty unserious document.
President Trump has done a great job with his platform. He's taken the Republican platform from 61 pages to 16 so that everybody can understand what we really believe in. And that way we can get more people, as you heard Ambassador Haley say, under our tent, because that makes us stronger having more people there.
Some people felt J.D. Vance as Trump's VP pick would be a uniting factor.
You've seen J.D. Vance work across the aisle. You've seen him try to get things done. I think he's a very pragmatic, very results-oriented person. And, you know, that's going to be very, very helpful, I think, as vice president.
He will do a wonderful job to work across the aisle and work and make America great again.
Haley wasn't the only former rival to take the stage. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis and Vivek Ramaswamy also made speeches on the second night of the RNC. We will have to wait and see if Republicans are convinced a speaking spot means they are welcome members of the Republican Party. From Milwaukee, Wisconsin, I'm Amy DeLora for Washington Examiner.